name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Peace be with you. The gospel reading of today reminds us of one of the great instances of our blessed Lord in raising the daughter of a Jewish ruler from death, as well as the healing of a woman who suffered issue of blood for 12 years. Unlike Matthew, Mark and Luke would tell us that the ruler's name was Jairus, and he was a leader of the synagogue whose duty was to appoint those who would read, pray, or preach at the synagogue. Of course, coming to Jesus could be as a last resort, for they regarded Jesus as a dangerous heretic. Jesus might have refused to help such an enemy, but then injured pride and unforgiving spirit had no part in the mind of Jesus. So we too, Christians, ought to emulate our master. Our blessed Lord therefore followed the Jewish ruler to his house only to discover a pandemonium of Eastern grief, whereby garments were being rent, professional wailing women hired to cry, and the flutes shrilling their airy sound, as it is a custom in every Jewish house of grief. One thing is certain, our blessed Lord that day at Capernaum authoritatively stopped such a hysterical atmosphere and rescued the daughter of Jairus from the grasp of death. That same day, our blessed Lord healed a woman with an issue of blood, a terrible and humiliating disease that renders the sufferer unclean in the whole of Palestine. Though this woman was shut off from the worship of God, yet she was able to gather a courageous faith that drew God's voluminous tenderness upon her. Very recently, a friend of mine lost his phone at Malema during one party night and cried bitterly to the chaplaincy, only to discover that the gates were already locked. And with a firm faith, he hurried to the gates of the church and cried to God. The following morning, he got his phone. This is not the kind of faith of which we expect holy water to be poured on us with anointing oil before we can receive healing. Let us build our faith in spite of the distance of God. God bless you.